it's quite clear that Maria is the one with the mushroom there. Taller for once than his brother Luigi. But this is Lucien Moylo as Mario and Luigi, ladies and gentlemen. Getting in lots of Goomba stomping practice. Lovely stuff. Did you enjoy that? Yeah? They're not our only kiddie cosplayers though, as from the pages of Marvel Comics and of course a movie which was probably of a different rating than suggests a kiddie entry in the Masquerade. This is Deadpool. The recent, incredibly child-friendly movie. No number three, OTEC team. We were going to have a third kiddie entry, but of course, sometimes kiddies need to go home early. So this will be number four. No, sorry. I updated the running order and actually remembered to remove the ones that dropped out. There is a number three. The original number three disappeared. This is number three. This is Rachel and Annie. They're here as Jester Harley Quinn and Suicide Squad Harley from, of course, the Batman franchise.
She ain't with it though, all because she got her own though. Boss, boss, if you don't know, she could never ever be a pro.
Times Harley Quinn. A lovely impromptu junior performance there. Okay, now this is actually one of the cosplayers here. This is their own little tribute to Anton Yechin. So this is Amy as Chekhov and Megan as McCoy from the recent 2009 Star Trek reboot. Now, from Star Trek to Star Wars, Andrew's here as Kylo Ren from Star Wars The Force Awakens.
Thank you.
like Kylo Ren from Star Wars. Keeping with the Western science fiction theme here, we now have Bethany, who's here as the girl who is running out of time from Doctor Who. Western sci-fi instead to a bit of a Bioshock video game affair, we have Charlie as Sarah from Dragon Age Inquisition. Sarah from Dragon Age Inquisition, otherwise known as I don't need to talk to my girlfriend for 2 months, she's playing Dragon Age. Got some Disney fans here? One or two? That's good, because Shannon here is coming on stage as Ariel from The Little Mermaid.
Ariel, not Ariel.
Come to a show is, I want to be where the people are. But where are the people? You're all right here, aren't you, ladies and gentlemen? Even more so when it's in London. Okay. Next on stage, I want you to welcome the toaster who always breaks and Sonic the Hedgehog. Gotta go fast.
Let's go.
tentacles, genos, and the speed of sound, Sonic, from the fantastic Mandarin anime One Punch Man, with the opening theme there that is already a favourite at karaoke parlors, karaoke anime tunes. If you have not seen the show, I do strongly recommend it, especially if you hated the long fights of Dragon Ball Z, as the name One Punch Man is not wrong. From the Batman Arkham Asylum game, we've got Christopher now come to the stage as the Scarecrow.
How many more bones would you crush? How many lives will you destroy in pursuit of what you call justice? You are the product of everything you fear. Violence, darkness, helplessness. All that remains is for you to watch as I drag your beloved Gotham into oblivion.
Claire is our next cosplayer, and it's Disney's Pixar's Blue Lady from Inside Out. It's Sadness. Claire there is Sadness from Inside Out. Do we have any fans of indie games in here? One or two? Anyone that had less money to spend this weekend because the Steam sale started just before the show opened? Well, for you all, it's Burger Pants and the Nice Ice Cream Guy, everyone's favourite vendors from Undertale. Nice ice cream guy there, the vendors from Undertale. And if you're not aware of what Undertale is, then do go and educate yourself, because it's a surprisingly peculiar little game and well worth your time. I have a note that while this character is from The Legend of Zelda, this is most definitely not Zelda, do not get them confused. The main character, of course, from the Legend of Zelda games, it's Link. He's dived the depths of the Water Temple, conquered the Dark Realm, and now he's here. Thank you. The Legend of Zelda, Hyrule's most efficient lawnmower. From the Love Life School Idol Project, it's Ben Coleman here as Kotori Manami. I don't have enough hair to put it on, though. Oh, I did. Come to me. Would you like this back, or is it tainted forever now?
Where did it go?
Wait. So yes, that was... that's Elliot there, that's Katori, one of the girls from Love Life School Idol Project. Something very, very different now, something entirely less light and fluffy. You're in for a fright. It's Eva's Foxy from Five Nights at Freddy's. Which is the best video game to watch other people play. Following the events of Civil War, the relationship between Steve and Tony is a little frosty. I think they're clearly uniting to defeat Donald Trump. Once you finish dealing with Trump, we've got another floppy-haired idiot in the UK to deal with. From Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope, Jordan is now coming on stage as the Princess Leia. Are we all enjoying the masquerade? Woo! Do you know what makes watching the masquerade even better? If you don't stand over there and come in and sit down, come on. There's plenty of seats, plenty of cosplays to come. Come on in. You know you want to. All these people are on my feet, I find my butt's too sore. I'm giving my butt a rest. Come in and sit down. There's plenty of seats, especially over here. Can I not woo you? It's a much better angle as well, isn't it? You can hear my dulcet tones through the speakers much more clearly. It's also true. The seating is raked, you won't be behind umpteen people that you can't see over. The seating's so good that we don't even need to ask Gandalf to remove their hat.
Sorry.
Can I attempt any more? No? Okay. I suppose being stood up outside, it feels like a queue, and we always feel more comfortable when queuing. Unhinged, unpredictable and feared, even by her own faction, Arendi channels bursts of chaotic energy to ravage her opponents at incredible speed. This is Kelly as Arendi from Battle War. Outlaws, or even the Teen Titans? Starfire is here, looking for them. Excellent cartoon. No, I mean the original one. Our next cosplayer is Kristen, and she is here as Midna from Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess. For Zelda personally. I know we must have some comic book and Marvel Cinematic Universe fans here. Coming on stage now, it's Mark as the 1940s Captain America. He is the Star Spangled Man. A line of dancing girls as well. I don't know who you're expecting to come up on stage now, but actually, it's him, Dio. This is Matthew as Dio Brando from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. If you haven't heard of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, if occasionally you're reading comics or watching cartoons and anime and you're thinking, this just isn't manly enough, I need a much manlier anime, try JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. There are a few things as manly as that. Right. I'd like to thank Comics Cosplayer for writing this particular introduction for me. Give it up for a humble vaudevillian veteran, cast vicariously as both victim and villain by the vicissitudes. It's me. From the amazing comic which was adapted into a movie, V for Vendetta. No, it's not called Anonymous. It was the comic character first. No, number 24, Otech Team. And I'm correct this time. So number 25, we have Red's domain here as Lionel Hatter, the Mad Hatter from Alice in Wonderland. Who did in fact finish his cup of tea before coming on stage. The next cosplayer is completely creepy but in a completely different way to the Mad Hatter who blew a kiss at a married woman judging. This is Sarah as a little sister from Bioshock. Big Daddy Dolly there is called Augustus. Our next cosplayer is jumping out of the screen. the screen of the movie The Hunchback of Notre Dame, this is Sarah Jane as Esmeralda, the finest girl in France. Esmeralda from The Hunchback of Notre Dame, complete with tambourine. For you esports fans, we have a couple of League of Legends cosplays now. Please welcome to stage Courtney as Ari and Vicky as Annie from the esports heat League of Legends.
But like a different version. GG cosplay is Arya.
Courtney and Vicky there as the terrors of the mid lane, Arya and Annie from League of Legends. Right. Our next entry was initially just one man. But he was one man with a mission, which was to rope every other deep sea cosplayer he could find into this particular entry. So bear with us, this might take a little while, because coming up onto the stage, we have the heroes and villains of DC, including but not necessarily limited to the Joker, Harley Quinn, Bane, Catwoman, Black Mask, Professor Pig, Riddler, Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, Deathstroke, and Batgirl. About cosplays is the social aspects, making friends and finding other people that love the same things you are. Because in my opinion, because a cosplay is much more effective than something like a football kit for going up on stage with. Okay. Let me have a word with the judges, see how long they will need and how long I will need to fill for. Okay, I'm judging. Now, Remember that not every entry chooses to enter competitively, some people don't get judged, but they have picked three winners. I understand, yeah, that's fine, right. We do have some winners to announce, but I also have a special request that we'll do, if you don't mind, we'll do something after we've had the winners on stage, which is, we have a cosplayer over here who was too late to join the Masquerade, but he quite wants to know what it's like to step out on stage in costume. So if any of you haven't taken part, but you're wondering actually, what would it be like to step out on stage? Okay, once we've had the winners up on stage, after that, we've got plenty of time at the moment, we had a nice early Masquerade, so if you're ever wondering what it's like to step out on stage, not going to be able to arrange music or anything, or announcements or anything, step out on stage in costume, I think we can manage that, can't we? That'll be fine, okay? Okay, winners first, and then open stage session for any cosplayers that just want to know what it's like to set foot on stage. You probably won't have much of an audience. That might help you. Excellent. Okay. Our two judges here. Now, not everyone chooses to compete, but some people do. And that's absolutely fantastic. We're completely open to people just having fun in the Masquerade. But from the people that chose to compete, and our two judges who have spent the day interviewing cosplayers and examining them up close, have chosen three winners. In third place, I would like to invite Kelly back onto stage for her Arendi cosplay from Battle War. Can raise any of your four hands.
She gone?
Is she gone?
Yep. Did she?
Oh, no. I would imagine that costume was also quite warm by this point in the day. Found her? Excellent. I would have thought that she did stick out in the crowd, to be honest. Fantastic stuff there. So third place is Kelly as Arendi from Battleborn. And to join her, could we possibly have Charlie, who is Sarah from Dragon Age Inquisition? Fantastic, would you like to come to the front here as well? And in first place, and I don't doubt that the judges would have loved to have given out more prizes if they could have done. And once we've got the winners together, we'll get a photo of just the winners. Then if other masqueraders wants to come on for a group photo, we'll do that after. And then we'll have the open stage for people who are trialing it. But let's do the winners first. First place goes to Kirsten for her Starfire costume. Winner's podium here. Congratulations, my dear. She's all alight. So, ladies and gentlemen, these are your Sunday cosplay Masquerade for MCM Northern Ireland Comic Con Masquerade winners. That's Kirsten as Starfire, Charlie as Sarah, and Kelly as Arendi. Let's get some photos of them together. And then wouldn't it be lovely to have all the cosplayers back on stage, don't you think, for a nice group photo? Okay. Just wait for those cameras to go off a couple more times. And of course, a big round of applause for everyone who took part, all of our cosplayers. Would our cosplay masqueraders like to come up onto the stage now and join one last time? Nice group photo of you all.
We're so sorry.
Let's come out.
Sorry.
You've been a wonderful, wonderful audience, but the cosplayers are what make this happen. Fantastic stuff to each and every one of them. Thank you all for taking part. And And like watch I said, once we've cleared the stage, it'll be, if anyone does want to bring their costume up onto stage, just to know what it feels like, then you're more than welcome to do so. If you are tall,